Valentine's Day, a popular time of year for marriage proposals, but too often people let love blind them from all the realities of life as a couple. Experts say you should know what kind of debt your prospective mate could be bringing into the union, and that's not all. People should talk openly about combining finances long before walking down the aisle. Maybe that's easier said than done. We'll get some advice on how to do that. Gene Todd, Managing Director of First Bank, is here to offer some financial tips that will hopefully build a stronger relationship. Good afternoon to you.
Hey, good afternoon, Ellie.
We often do hear that people really do sort of fight over money, and it might be one of those things that sort of builds up over time. So I guess the first question is, you know, these can be really personal conversations to have. So what's some advice on kind of beginning that conversation to make sure we're all kind of being honest and open here?
First thing you got to do is agree to have the conversation and lay everything on the table. Full disclosure, we like to call it discovery. So everyone needs to come clean about what their personal situation is, what their assets are, how much money they make, what their expenses look like, their investments. Sometimes there's some negative information you need to share too. Have you ever had late payments, a bankruptcy? All these things can be rectified, but the first thing you have to do is make sure that both parties put everything on the table and everyone has full disclosure.
That's probably even more of an issue today as people are getting married a little bit later in life. Before, you know, my parents got married when they were 20, you didn't have any money, right? It's almost easier when you have nothing to talk about. But now if you're getting married in your late 30s or 40s, you know, you probably have a retirement account, you maybe have some debt, you maybe have some credit issues, all those things that need to be talked about before you become one in terms of a financial union.
You got to talk about them, and even though people are getting married much later in life, guess what the life expectancy is
right
now? It's well into the 80s,
longer,
so
yeah.
People are going to live a long, long time. What we like to suggest is that both parties come together and define what success looks like for them. For example, when you're both in your 80s and you're sitting around, how would you describe financial success? Right? Do you, what sort of money do you have in the bank? Is your house paid for? Do you have money set aside to give to your favorite charity? How much money do you want to leave to your kids, your grandkids? And so once you define all of that, then build a roadmap on how to get there. Starting from today to when you get into your 80s, it's very important to design that roadmap. And sometimes things change. Roadmaps
sure,
will change along the way depending on your life situations. Have babies. A parent might get sick, you lose a job. So roadmaps can change, but it's very important to have one in the onset.
Are you a big fan of a budget as well?
Budgets are key, right? You got to know how much you're going to spend. And what I like to tell couples to do is have three accounts. Have my account, have your account, and have our account.
Oh, so you do like that?
I like that because how much am I going to spend for haircuts, for new suits?
That's on
how
you.
Much, that's on me. How much are you going to spend for hair appointments mm-hmm. and going out and having drinks with your friends? And so it's very important to establish those boundaries.
That's okay. That is interesting. And then, is there sort of a formula for how you determine what money goes in which accounts, or is that kind of up to the couple to figure that out?
It's up to the couple. Everybody's got to be reasonable, but again, you've got to make sure that you have that sort of conversation. The R account is the important account used to accomplish those goals, those dreams that you have down the road.
Yeah.
And whatever's left over, make it reasonable and split it.
That sounds good. I mean, and this sounds like conversations that should be had about money, but that could probably lead to other conversations that would be very important to have before getting married as well. So maybe this is just one way to kind of get there.
One way to get there, a very important way to get there, and people should do that early on.
Sounds good. Gene Todd from First Bank, thank you so much. We appreciate it.
Thank you.
Happy
Glad
Valentine's
to be here.
Day.
Thanks. Same. Thank you.